Hey everyone, we're back, and as you can see, it's another overcast day here in this area. This time no rain, at least there were little drops, but at least not yet. But anyway, we had started out this recording by talking about knowing your numbers, and we were going in for our physical exam. And I just want to tell you that everything went well, and we're going to the vehicle right now. And when we talk about knowing your numbers, we talked about blood pressure, we talked about cholesterol, and not just any cholesterol levels, but we want to mention the LDL, which are the HDL should be low, and the HDL should be high, and your LDL should be low. So the LDL is what they call the bad cholesterol, and your HDL, H for happy, is your good cholesterol. So I will know my results hopefully in a few weeks. But in the meantime, what I want to do is get in the car and just show you my little list here. So just bear with me here. Okay, we're in the car, and I just want to show you the list that I had. These are the questions that I had, and I'm just going to show them to you real quickly. I have everything checked off. My note on my way back to work, my mammogram referral. I also talked about vitamin D because that was a concern for me. They did a preliminary EKG on me, and that came out okay. My resting heart rate is 60, which is good. And by the way, regarding resting heart rate should be low. The lower your numbers are on your resting heart rate, that means the less work your heart is doing in a inactive mode. In other words, in a sitting mode, in a sedentary mode. If your resting heart rate is high, meaning there's a certain range, and if it's over that range, like how many beats your heart is pumping per minute, then that means you're in trouble, and you could be on the borderline or could have some cardiovascular disease or be in the early stages of that. So that is something that you can check not only with your doctor, but there are monitors out there. You can also take your own pulse by doing your carotid radial, your carotid artery, which is right here, excuse me, in the neck, and you don't want to cross over, but you want to do it on the same side, and you can count how many beats per minute by using a stop clock that your heart is beating, or you could do the radial, the wrist. So I'm going to try to show that right here. Okay, so either way you can do that. So again, we just want to show you this, and we also have our referrals for future exams. I like to get a yearly mammogram, even though recent research showed that women are not required to do it. But my doctor says, you know, her advice on that is if you want to do that, that's fine. But at the same time, you never know. That also goes, ladies, for the pap smears. If you have normal pap smears, you're not required to get them every year. I believe it's every 2 to 3 years. But as my doctor advises me, and she does this herself, she says, you never know, because you never know what's going to come up from year to year. So we have our referrals here. I'm going to just show those to you real quick. That's this one here. That's this one here. And now I have to get a separate appointment for one other exam. So anyway, hope that helps you. You guys take care, and remember to always live well. Bye now.